This shooting occurred on January 26, 2018 at the 11,000 block of El Cador. This incident began at 12:08 a.m. when officers were called to the 11,000 block of Giles Street for reports of a shooting that ended up into a domestic-related murder. Before I get into the details of the incident, I want to first talk about domestic violence and what LVMPD does to stop domestic violence. We encourage any person who's involved in a domestic violence-type relationship to call us, call a friend, or call any other resource that's out there to get out of that sort of relationship, because a lot of these domestic violence homicides could be decreased if people involved in those relationships do seek help. And we want to also intervene before the tragedy then occurs. I'll now detail the incident as we know it today. Basically, this was OIS number 1 of 2018. At the same time last year, it was OIS number 2, and this is our first fatal of the year also. The date and time of the original call was January 26, 2018, and it came out as an assault battery with a gun. The location of the OIS was in very close proximity of that residence. That was at the 11,000 block, which is 11,636 El Cador Street near Barbara Lane and Giles Street. You can see to the scene to my left on the screen. The time of the OIS occurred at 0247 hours, which is 2:47 a.m. The involved officers were Officer Selena Cruz. She's 30 years of age and has been with LVMPD for 11 years. She's assigned to the Community Policing Division at the South Central Area Command. In this incident, Officer Cruz was armed with a Remington 870 12-gauge shotgun, and it's department issued. The investigation revealed that Officer Cruz fired 3 rounds from her shotgun. The Officer Cruz was wearing her body-worn camera during this incident, and it was activated, and I'll show you the video at the conclusion of my remarks. Officer Anthony Raymond was the second officer involved. He is 33 years of age, and he's been with LVMPD for 11 years. He is assigned to the Community Policing Division, also at the South Central Area Command. In this incident, Officer Raymond was armed with a Colt AR-15 A3-223 rifle, and it was equipped with a tactical light. The investigation revealed Officer Raymond fired 11 rounds from his rifle during this incident. Our suspect decedent is Axel Vivas. He's 42 years of age. He's a Hispanic male adult, 5'2", 180 pounds. Vivas is pictured to my left. Vivas's criminal history is he had none prior. Vivas's charges, if he survived, was murder, attempt murder on a protected person, 8 counts, assault with a deadly weapon, 8 counts, resisting arrest with a firearm, 8 counts. Vivas's weapon, which will be pictured to my left, was a Taurus 38 revolver. He had 5 live cartridges in the weapon. No rounds were fired by Vivas on this incident, and the revolver belonged to Vivas. Details on the OIS. On Friday, January 26, 2018, at 12:08 a.m., dispatch received a call from 11729 Giles Street, reference of female shot. The caller was the son of the victim and told dispatch that his stepfather, Axel Vivas, was the suspect. Patrol officers arrived, and the caller exited the residence with his 3 younger siblings who were in the residence at the time also. Patrol officers made entry, located the female victim in the residence, and requested medical. Medical personnel pronounced the female deceased at the scene. Vivas was no longer at the scene upon officers' arrival, and it was determined he fled in a white Chrysler Sebring with Tennessee plates. Homicide detectives responded to the scene and began their investigation. The investigation revealed that Vivas was in possession of a revolver. He had reloaded it after he had shot his wife and made suicide by cops statements before fleeing. As homicide conducted the investigation at the scene, patrol detectives were out along with other patrol officers canvassing the area looking for the suspect. At approximately 2:40 a.m., officers located the vehicle in a nearby neighborhood parked across from 11,636 El Cador. At 2:44 a.m., Vivas exited his vehicle with the firearm in hand. During that time, officers attempted to de-escalate the situation and gave Vivas numerous verbal commands to drop the weapon. Vivas was highly agitated, yelling at officers, waving the firearm around, and pointing it in the direction of the officers. At approximately 2:47 a.m., Vivas pointed his firearm at officers and at officers Cruz and Officer Raymond. Vivas took cover behind the vehicle and popped up at least two times, pointing the firearm at the officers. Officer Cruz and Raymond continued to fire and struck Vivas. Vivas went down and officers approached to render aid. Medical personnel was requested and pronounced Vivas dead on the scene. I will now show the video obtained from Officer Cruz and the air unit video as well, so that you can get a further perspective on the incident.
Come in behind. I'm coming behind you. I'm coming behind you with a long gun. Coming behind you. Joe.
Just stay on this side of the car right here.
I'm not lying to you.
Can you see him from there?
Right. I'm not lying to you.
Shit.
We can work this out.
I got long gun, Joe.
We can work this out. Come on, man. Come on. Let's talk about this. I don't want to hurt you. All I want to do is talk. All I want to do is talk. Can we get the bird high?
Shit. He's blocking.
He's got a gun. He's right underneath those feet.
We can't. I can't. He's blocking our.
I don't want to do this. I don't want to. Come on, man. Please, let's talk. Let's talk. I don't want to put you out of your misery. I want to talk. I want to talk. Come on, bro. Come on. Let's talk. Let's talk. Hold on. Hey, bro. Let's talk.
Shot fired. Put it down.
Put the gun down. Go on.
Ken, as you can see, there was a real long de-escalation time trying to get the suspect to drop the weapon, and obviously the officer's attempts weren't good enough, and he didn't listen to the commands. This is the second video from the air unit, which gives a good perspective from the air, and it'll show the suspect's actions very clearly when you see it.
Air 2 affirmative. Yeah, he's pointing the gun southbound towards officers. We could just set up some containment north of. We're going to need that at.
Level 5. Can you reassign me to 0328?
3, we got shots fired. Shots fired.
Yeah, shots fired. 11 shots fired. 11 copy. BC-11, did officers fire shots?
There are two suspects still crouched down. He's still got the 413.
Air 2.
That's it. I'll now open it up for any questions.
How many times was Vivas actually struck? Or at what point was he struck? Was it toward the end?
It was towards the end. That's why they continued firing. He took three rounds, I think one in the hand, and one to the side of the head and one in the head. Yes, sir.
During the first video you showed, you could hear an officer, or it sounded like an officer in the background saying something along the lines of, I'm not lying to you, let's talk to this. Is that the second officer who fired the gun, not Officer Cruz?
No, usually the way it works on scene, there were officers already there negotiating with him. So a lot of the times we utilize the officers that show up later who are on gun so they can concentrate on the suspect if we have time to set up there, which we did. But our plainclothes officers and other officers had arrived prior, were able to lock him in as other officers arrived on the scene, and we were able to get a plan to negotiate with him. That wasn't the two officers that fired. They you heard the female say drop the gun. She may have yelled one or two commands, but the other officers were the officers who arrived prior.
Is there any there any more information on the homicide? Did they live together? Was there a problem that preceded?
From what we know, it was a domestic violence related homicide. They were married. They had three children in common, and she had a previous child from the previous previous marriage. And from what we know, they had no prior calls to the police.
Did any of the children witness the shooting?
He's 16 years old, almost an adult. He was our person who reported the crime to the police. So yes, he had witnessed a portion of it.
And is there any indication that this man, that Vivas was under the influence of anything, had any prior mental issues or anything of that sort?
No information on that, but according to the details, he had lost his job prior, and they had had problems, but nobody had ever called the police prior in regards to the problems they were having in the home.